Guys, I just want to do a little disclaimer there. Right before we went on, we saw that the market sold off and Peter went to investigate and came back with some answers for us. So luckily we have him here on the floor. Peter, I know it's going to be a busy day. So thanks for jumping on camera. What happened?
Hi, guys. You know what? It's always fascinating to analyze when you have these moves like this. Market, so we were down 300 yesterday, and it seems that the focus, since the market tends to focus on one or more things that make it sort of, whether it's headline driven, whether it's sort of algo driven or what. But lately, you know, we haven't been able to explain the huge rally except for the fact that the tax reform and all that stuff, but it kept going higher than that explanation would hold, right? And then we get levels where the market just sort of flatlines off the top and you're trying to figure that out. And there's always a catalyst to what this market does. You and I talked about last week, it feels like volatility is back in the market. That's a good thing. But it's kind of dangerous and worrisome to see, not worrisome, it's curious to see and try to explain a market that yesterday's market was down 300, completely a focus on Fed's on Powell, right? So the market didn't get pummeled yesterday. It got Powelled. I saw that headline and I kind of like that. What could have been a really bad February turns out to be kind of a flat February. You don't know what March is going to bring. The fundamentals seem the same. So why not take a little off the table? That's my, you know, that's an intraday sort of forensic breakdown of what could be going on. And I'm not that smart.
That's a great title for that. But listen, you say that volatility is back. Now, to trade volatility, don't you have to be a pretty savvy trader?
You know what? I don't. Look, you have investors and you have traders. There are a lot of people in the trading space. You have enough people in the trading space, whether it's hedge funds or individual traders, to move a market like this. You really do. There are some big people with big pockets out there trading the S&P, trading individual stocks, trading the triple Qs, the Dow, right? There are a lot of ETFs. You know, you're seeing a lot of activity in ETFs. When we talk about volatility, I'm not talking about the VIX. I'm just talking about, for me, volatility means up 150, down 60. And the trend is your friend. So if you're, you know, this morning, you know, and I'm also a firm believer from the trading point of view. And as you know, I've never owned a share of stock. So this is my breakdown of what other people are doing, is that you know, to take an acceptable profit and not wait around for an unacceptable loss. If I have profits in my month here and the market is down 300 yesterday, we got a rally this morning of up 100, why not take a little off the table? Am I going to wait and turn that profit into, by now, I was long maybe a loser, right? So when people see that rollover, their guy's going to go, you know what, I'm out. Now, we're seeing a little bit of a bounce back. We went from up 150 to down 60 very quickly. Now we're seeing a little dead cat bounce here. Where is the follow through? It's the end of the month. It's the end of February. Tomorrow we're going to see some more fresh money coming into the market. Apparently people are getting a lot of bonuses coming in out there. It's been a great year for Wall Street.